Alright, now we are going to talk about the herpes virus. We have talked about the herpes virus family kind of viruses, but now entirely about the herpes virus. Whenever someone hears this name herpes virus, it's always some pictures in mind which is related to the sexual transmitted disease or STDs, and that is common with the herpes viral infection. And herpes virus is a cause of predominant genital warts as well as the sore. Different words in the mouth as well, mouth ulcers and that related to other issues. We are going to talk about all of this. So if you want to know about the herpes virus, stay tuned to this video, because we are also going to talk about the classification of herpes virus as well as the life cycle of herpes virus. So let's begin the basic information. So before that, let me take a color. The basic information of this herpes virus goes like, we call it herpes simplex virus or HSV. There are two types of this, HSV type 1 and HSV type 2, also known by their taxonomical names, that is human alpha herpes virus 1 and human alpha herpes virus 2. And the two members of human herpes viridae family, a set of new viruses that produce viral infection in the majority of humans, herpes virus 1 and herpes virus 2, remember. And they are also known as the alpha herpes virus. Both HSV 1 and HSV 2 are common and contagious. And the difficult thing about the herpes virus is that the genital herpes is kind of incurable. So that's one big issue. How does it look like? Okay, so all this kind of herpes virus family virus look exactly kind of similar. We've earlier discussed about the cytomegalovirus, which belong to this kind of family, so they are also similar in the structure. So what you can clearly see here is that have a unique four layered structure. Okay, four different layers are present. One is the core containing the large double-stranded DNA genome. Okay, so at the core there is a DNA genome. This is the DNA, this is the core, this is the first layer of organization. Then the icosahedral capsid, this is the capsid, this is the second layer of organization. And then the capsid is surrounded by an amorphous protein coat, which is known as a tegument protein. So this blue color structure is the tegument protein here, okay? So this is the third layer of organization here. And the fourth one is the lipid bilayer, which is made with glycoprotein. So glycoprotein means these are envelope proteins on the surface. Okay, these are glycoproteins or receptors with which this virus will interact with the host cell and can be engulfed by the host cell and can help itself to initiate the process of viral particle release immediately. So these are the four levels. So this is the fourth level. These are the fourth level of organization in case of any of this herpes virus family. What is the size of herpes virus? It will be bigger, because if it has a four different layers of organization, obviously it will be bigger. It is 155 to 240 nanometer in diameter. That is a comparatively big virus. It has icosahedral capsid with a diameter of 125 nanometers. So imagine the diameter of the icosahedral capsid is 125 nanometers, while the overall diameter of the spherical virus is 155 to 240 nanometer, which means inside of which there are more matrix tegument protein and all this protein component. What is the genetic material type? Double-stranded DNA. So it has a DNA genome. Okay, what kind of disease it causes? There are two set of diseases we talked about earlier. One causing contagious sores, okay, most often around the mouth or around the genitals, either in the mouth sore like this or the sores near genitals. What is the incubation period for the herpes simplex virus? The average incubation period is 4 days, but it can range from 2 to 12 days after the exposure towards the herpes simplex virus. What is the mode of transmission? The mode of transmission of HSV-1 mainly by oral to oral contact, okay, and that causes oral herpes infection or the oral sores. And it also has, like HSV-1, sores, it can transfer by saliva and surfaces in or around the mouth. It is present there. However, HSV-1 can also be transmitted through genital area through oral genital contact to cause genital herpes. So this is related to the STD segment or sexually transmitted disease segment. It can transfer oral to oral or oral to genital mode. What are the symptoms of herpes virus related infection? So for the cold sores, that is the oral herpes, cause tiny fluid filled lesions called cold sores or fever blisters, which can recur very, very often. The pain areas for cold sores is mouth, sore lip, tingling lips and ulcer there in the lips and mouth. Skin cause blistering of the skin, rashes, ulcer and redness. and also common is a burning sensation. But on the other hand, if you talk about the genital herpes, in that case, after the initial infection, the genital herpes lies dormant in the body for a while, and then the symptoms can recur for years after years because it is incurable and the virus is very difficult to get rid of, so it will recur and it will cause a problem in penis and vagina. Pain circumstances can occur during urination. There will be immense pain and burning sensation. Also, there is a common genital sores, sensation of pins and needles, in that area, and also there are skin rashes that is visible in this picture clearly. So this is what this herpes virus causes. Let's look at the scientific classification of herpes virus, and then we'll also talk about the types of herpes virus. The classification begins with family, that is herpes viridi or herpes viridi. Herpes viridi family has this similar kind of structure of the viral particle. Order is herpes virals. Kingdom, Hungongviri, and class is herpesvirusets. Genus, simplex virus. Phylum, Peploviricota. Now let's look at the classification of human pathogens of this herpes virus, and there are these three different kinds of the herpes virus: alpha herpes virinae, beta herpes herpes virinae, and gamma herpes virinae. So alpha herpes virin or virinae, you can say the alpha herpes virus, beta herpes virus, and gamma herpes virus. The alpha herpes virus can be type 1, type 2, and varicella zoster virus. So HSV1, HSV2 belong to alpha herpes virus, and these are the two which is common for human infections, the cold mouth sores and genital sores by HSV1, and then varicella zoster virus or VZV. Beta herpes virus, cytomegalovirus, we have talked about CMV earlier. Okay, mononucleus is the disease that it causes. Human herpes virus type 6 or HHV6 and HHV7 is also part of beta herpes virus. And gamma herpes virus example is Epstein-Barr virus. We also talked about the Epstein-Barr virus or EBV. So if you want to know in details about the cytomegalovirus or Epstein-Barr virus, then I'll recommend you to watch my lecture on cytomegalovirus and Epstein-Barr virus separately. It's present in this channel. Now let's look at the life cycle of this. Now, the life cycle and the structures of the similar the herpes virus family, that is herpes viridi family of the viruses, are very much similar with one another. So if you know about the cytomegalovirus life cycle or EBV, Epstein-Barr virus life cycle, then this life cycle of herpes virus will also be very much similar for you. So it starts with the attachment like any other virus. After the attachment, there is fusion of the viral membrane with that of the host cell membrane, and that releases the capsid, icosahedral capsid, along with its genetic material, that is double-stranded DNA, which is known as together as a nucleocapsid. And then the component of this DNA, which is circular, is released into the nucleus. The circular DNA goes inside the nucleus, and this circular DNA will make more mRNA. Okay, mRNA preparation will be done there, and inside of which you can see that at this moment the viral DNA replication inhibitors are there that we developed to prevent it. But similarly, what happens is virus does is simply after inserting its genome inside the host nucleus, they start making their own mRNA. Once the mRNAs are prepared, it's transported into the cytosol and they are translated into the protein components. Okay, once the protein components are produced, these protein components with the help of the concatemeric DNA that is produced, generally in this case there is a circular DNA that is inserted inside the host nucleus, and then using this DNA as a template, they start making more and more new copies of the DNA which need to be packaged inside the genetic inside the structural capsids, right? So once the viral structural proteins are made in cytosol, they are transported back inside the nucleus, and the viral assembly begins inside the nucleus. Remember all this always, where exactly the viral assembly begins, in nucleus or cytosol? In this case, the viral assembly of the icosahedral capsid begins inside the nucleus, and from the circular DNA, they continue to make the genetic double-stranded DNA, genetic material of the virus, and they have multiple concatemeric DNA, means they have concatemer structures and multiple regions where they cut the DNA segments at a particular distance, at a particular length, and the particular length of the DNA is inserted back inside the capsid structure there. Okay, so once that is done, once the packaging is done, then this virus this nucleocapsid structure will move out of the nucleus. Okay, final envelopment will be done of the final envelopment of the virus will be done here in the cytosol, and the viral egress out of the cell. This is the overall idea about how the herpes simplex virus cause infection. But in this picture, we have seen different drugs that target different stages of this herpes virus infection, because herpes virus is a very common cause of infection in US. So that's why a lot of research has been going on, and what we found out is kind of there are multiple examples what we found out, multiple drugs that we found out that helps us to fight against this kind of herpes virus infection. So you can see that there are drugs at all different levels. There is a drug that can inhibit the DNA replication here. There is a drug that can inhibit the fusion of the viral glycoprotein with the host surface receptor. There is also an inhibitor that prevents the egression of the virus. So there is also another inhibitor. They have different names provided here, the inhibitor that can inhibit the synthesis of the viral proteins. So there are different drugs found out to be involved in different stages of the viral infection that can prevent the viral infection. Okay, so we have this experimental drug always ready, and we continue to test them to find out a best cure against the herpes virus or herpes simplex virus 1 or HSV1. So that's all about the life cycle of the herpes virus and the details about the herpes virus. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to this channel to get more and more videos like that in future. Thank you.